I'm going to teach you how to automate content for your WordPress blog. This system takes in the most recent news articles and repurposes them for your website. And as always, you can download the free template and link in the description below. And let's get right into the video. All right, guys, so here's the system. Let's get into a live demo. First, we're going to pull in a news article in our Google Sheets trigger right here on the left. Perplexity is then going to summarize it. The AI agent is going to repurpose it for our website, based on what we tailor and what we tell it to do. And it's going to post it to our WordPress. So let's run a live demo here. So it's connected to my Google Sheet. So this is the Google Sheets that it's connected to. And the purpose is for us to put in a new article at the bottom row here, and it will then go through the automation and repurpose it for us. So let's do a live test. So AI agents news, and say we want to take in this most recent article, which was 42 minutes ago. Sure, we'll repurpose this one. It's hot. Let's run it. Put that into our Google Sheets as the latest row, and let's test this workflow. Google Sheets is executing, code runs, Perplexity is summarizing it right now. The AI agent's repurposing it for us, and it's going to post to our WordPress. Okay, guys, there you go. So did what it needs to do. Let's check this out. WordPress, okay. The post, introducing AI agents, revolutionizing work efficiency. The title, three new ways AI agents can help you do even more. Okay, so we come over to my WordPress here, and there you go. Three new ways AI agents can help you do even more. Let's check on the draft and see how it is. Okay, so we got our title, couple H2s. H3s, and a conclusion. So there you go. Let's publish it and see how it actually looks within the website. All right, let's view this. Okay, and so this is what it will look like when you post it, depending on your site structure and how your posts are set up. But it automates the content for you, and this was the whole point of the automation. So I'm happy with this, and obviously it can be customized however you want, but this is just a simple guideline on how we can automate the content for your WordPress blogs. So that's the system, guys. If you want to download this, like I said, it's right in the description below. If you want to do a live build, then that's what we'll get into next. All right, guys, so let's do the live build here. I'm going to lay out the entire automation instead of doing it one by one, and then we'll go through the settings after. So first we'll add a Google Sheets trigger on row updated. This is just the way I like to do it. I like to see it all laid out, and I hope you guys learn the same way as I do. If not, that's okay. But we'll go through it anyways. So after that, we will add in a code snippet, and this code snippet will allow us to pull the most recent article. Next, we have an HTTP request, which we will set up to be Perplexity. Fix these up right now so it makes more sense and we're all organized. We'll name this code retrieve latest article, and we can name this, we'll leave that as Google Sheets trigger. After the Perplexity HTTP request, we're going to add an AI agent, and we will give it a brain. I will use OpenRouter. You can use whatever LLM you would like to use. If you don't know how to do this, you have to set an API key either through ChatGPT, OpenAI, or whatever. You can use OpenRouter as well. Same thing goes for Perplexity. You need to set up the API key for it, and we'll go through that in a second. So after the AI agent, we will add another code that will make sure to pull the title for us. I had a bit of troubles just with the AI agent pulling the title accurately every time, so we'll name this title pull code. That didn't do it for me. Name it title pull, enter. And the last node will be the WordPress node, create a post. And this is the entire structure laid out. So Google Sheets will pull in that article. We'll pull the most recent one. Perplexity will summarize it. The AI agent will repurpose it. Make sure to pull the title from the AI agent output, and then we'll post it to WordPress. Okay, guys, so in the Google Sheets trigger, we have to connect our credentials. So you'll come here, you'll create a new credential. I've already done mine, but what you need to do is set up a Google OAuth account. That was one of the first videos I made, so go ahead and watch that. Once you're all set up there, then we can come over to the documents, select this right here, which will be the YouTube demo, Google Sheets, and then we'll select sheet number one. And we'll make sure it's on, the trigger is on row updated. That way, every time we put in a new article, it will take the most recent one. Now for this section here, for the code, we need to enter something that makes sure we're pulling the most recent article link right here. Otherwise, it'll just keep repeating and repurposing the same content, and we don't want that. So I'm gonna leave the code here for you guys to copy and write out. Okay, sorry guys, my camera died there. Had to swap the batteries. So here's the code. I'm gonna leave this here for you guys to copy out. And as I said before, you can download the free template and link in my description below. But here it is, just copy this out and you'll be good. All right guys, so let's move into Perplexity. We're gonna add in this URL right here and click send headers, use fields below and authorize bearer dash. After this dash is where you're gonna add in your API code from Perplexity, which we'll go over in a second. And we're gonna send body using JSON and we're going to add in this right here. So this will just tell Perplexity what model to use, what to do, the article to pull from the Google Sheets trigger. And that's the Perplexity node, guys. So what you're gonna wanna do is go over to perplexity.ai and we'll need an API key. So once you have the Perplexity account, you're gonna come over to my account, go down to API keys, and then you'll generate an API key. And what you'll do is you'll come over and add it right after this dash, and then you'll be authorized. So you're gonna have to add in, you know, maybe $5 into your Perplexity billing account. Once you're done that, you'll be all good to go. All right, let's move on to the AI agent. I'm gonna give you this prompt here. So we're going to change this to define below and add in a system message. And let's paste this in. So this system prompt basically just tells it the structure, to use H2s, to use paragraphs. I had to mess around with this a little bit so it actually came out properly. So you can just download this and use it if you want, or you can copy it and just type it in yourself and customize it how you want, and hopefully it comes out the same. So based on the following article summary, create a tailored blog post for WordPress with a separate title and content. Here's some title guidelines, and here is how they should format the response, some content guidelines, and then the article summary, which we're gonna go through after, which will be from the Google Sheets trigger. So let's move on to the title pull code. I had a bit of difficulties with the AI agent producing a title every time, so I would have to create it for myself in WordPress. But with this code, which I will show you right here, it actually scrapes the title perfectly every time. So if you just enter this code right here, if you enter this code right here, it'll pull the title for you. You can try it without this, but I found I had a little bit of difficulty. So you can download this or type it out as you want. You could probably take a screenshot of this right now and get ChatGPT to type it out line for you. So I'll scroll through this for you guys slowly, and you can screenshot that into an AI model if you would like. Okay guys, so let's move on to the WordPress credentials. So you have to set up your WordPress account, and to do that, you will need to create a new credential. You'll need to add in a username and password. So you'll add in your website here, and then your username will most likely be your email address. And for your password, I'll show you how to do that. You have to go over. Okay guys, so you'll have to go over to users, and then most likely it'll be your email address. That it was mine at the top. And then you come here and type in a new application password name, and you add an application password, and then come back on over and you put that password and username in there along with your website name, and you'll have authorization into your WordPress site. Hey guys, so just tested that Google Sheets trigger. It pulled in the latest article, which was this Microsoft.com link, because we haven't ran it through the code yet. Guys, a little mistake there. I actually had the trigger on row updated and not added. So let's try this now. Row added. I just added in that link right there. So let's try this now. Fetch test event. Okay guys, so I was having a little bit of difficulty pulling in the most recent article from that last Google Sheets I had, which was the YouTube Google Sheets. So I just switched over to a different one and it seems to be working fine. So if that happens to you, then I would recommend creating a new one. So let's test this out. Let's test each event. So we'll test this, pulls all the media links, come over here, we'll test this. And it pulls the SiliconANGLE Enterprise at Sirius AI Agents. Yep, that's the most recent article in the Google Sheets. All right, next step is Perplexity. So Perplexity will summarize this for us. There we go. Role, assistant, content, the article, enterprise, da da da. So it summarized it for us right there. Move over to the AI agent and we'll test out this step. And right here, guys, when you get over to the AI agent step, you're gonna wanna pull in some content. So yeah, guys, pull in this content right here or however it outputs it on yours, but you're gonna wanna enter the content right into this prompt user message. Once it has that, then we can test the step. Once you have that, then we can test the step and use AI to repurpose it for us and make us a new article. All right, there we go. So output, title, enterprise, da da da. Okay, repurpose the entire article for us. Perfect. Now let's run this title poll and let's see here. So in the WordPress node, yep, right here, it's got the title enterprise. So it's using the same title as the article that we used from. So I want to keep the keywords the same. That way we're using the same titles and similar keywords to what's hot right now. So what you're going to want to do here is, I've already got it here, but so pull in the title right over here to title, and then it might say something different for you, like content, post, WordPress, but right here in content, you're going to want to pull over the post from the title poll, and there you have it. Now let's run this and it'll post it over to WordPress for us. Boom, just like that, it's done. Let's go ahead and check. So Stalwarts get serious about AI agents. Let's check that post out. And boom, there you have it. There's our article, perfect. Let's publish it and see how it looks. Okay, so it looks pretty good to me, guys. Has the title here, introduction to AI agents in the enterprise. So we got an H2 kind of introduction here and then H3s alongside of it, followed by a larger title to finish off. So there you go. That is how you automate content for your WordPress site through N8N. Thanks for watching the video, guys. Like, comment, subscribe, and let me know what video you want to see next, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.